A Star Wars fan's dream.
Casey, I tell you what, an absolute Star Wars fan's dream. This is one of the resistance fighters behind me. This is going to be one of the areas, of which there are many. This is a 14-acre expansion. $1 billion is what we're being told. I think it actually will rival that figure. It's extraordinary, particularly if you're into Star Wars, but the idea is it's accessible whether you know every tiny nuance or you're not entirely immersed. Chris Schauble and I have been here over the course of a couple days. We're going to show you around, and then we have an actual expert to answer even the most pertinent and detailed of Star Wars questions. Watch this. This is amazing.
This land is such an experience because we've created an entirely new planet here, right? The planet of Batuu, where the guests can experience it for the very first time.
Now, this is the First Order section of it, and as you can see, whoa.
Resistance activity was reported nearby. No one is above suspicion. Show me your identity card. And we're supposed to believe that's you. All right, let's please remain calm.
Sam's used to being hassled.
That's always here.
So we're in the section that's the First Order, and I love the ship. This is like every dad or mom who used to be a kid and then every kid's dream. This whole land is that to me. Is that the feeling you were going for?
It is so incredible. To your point, yeah, the fact that there is a TIE fighter that's landed here, the Millennium Falcon having landed over on the other side, that feeling that you can just see how the action has been happening here on Blackspire Outpost, that absolutely is the feeling that you just want to feel like you're a part of one of those stories, right? That you can walk through the markets, you can see the sights, smell the smells, taste the tastes. Have you tried some blue milk yet?
I have. It was excellent. One of the things that really amazed me is you really do feel it. You don't know that you're in Disneyland proper anymore. You really feel like you've been transported.
It's its own world.
All right, from two excited fans there, Matt Martin works for Lucasfilms. You started your Lucasfilm Star Wars career as a volunteer at Star Wars conventions?
Yeah. I was a big Star Wars fan ever since I was 8 years old, and eventually made it into volunteering at conventions and met some people through there and eventually just kind of worked my way into the company.
Well, I tell you what, this must be just a pinch-yourself experience right here.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm from Southern California, so Disneyland has always been a big part of my life, and being able to work on a Star Wars project in Disneyland was just, you know, the greatest experience.
But the one thing that really strikes me is that while we're in Disneyland, this is very removed from Disneyland.
Very much so. I mean, pretty much anywhere you stand, you can't see the rest of the park. So you really feel 100% completely immersed in Star Wars on the planet of Batuu.
Literally, as we're having the conversation, it occurred to me, I haven't seen Mickey or Minnie or any of those things. I suspect I won't see them.
No, they won't make their way here because they don't travel to Batuu. This is a galaxy far, far away.
And they've incorporated everything. The ride experience that we've told you about, all these different story items. And you suggested, and what we've learned through the course of the day, that much of this, I don't want to say following a script, but there's a story of this planet and a story people will experience as they come here.
Yeah, very much. We have a story developed for every little piece of the park. Every shop has a shopkeeper. That shopkeeper has a backstory. And then the wider story of the park is basically, it's set during the sequel trilogy, the new trilogy of films. And here on Batuu, we're kind of getting to experience the conflict between the First Order and Resistance in a place that was previously neutral.
Wow. Very, very interesting stuff. Casey and Glenn, the other thing is, it is almost entirely likely you'll never see it this unpopulated again. We were reflecting on that. When the crowds come in starting tomorrow, they're going to come in, and they're never not going to come in. Should also tell you this, one big ride already open later this year, maybe a few months away. What some people are telling me is the most ambitious ride in Disney history, a huge e-ticket attraction, which is called Rise of the Resistance. That's still a few months away, but otherwise, it opens tomorrow, reservations for the first month. Otherwise, anyone welcome, and I think they will pour in. We'll go back to you two in Hollywood.
So take your selfie now, Sam, because you're not going to get another chance. Crowds are going to be big.